channel. My name is Emma. And we're doing, yeah, got both microphones working. Alright, so today's flight, or this evening's flight, I don't know where everyone is, will take me into, remember how yesterday I went into Everest and sort of crashed around, what is it called? That Luka Airport, or Tenzing-hillary, or whatever they call it. Anyway, so we're taking off from here, which is a place I can't even pronounce. So, yeah. So we're going to a flight in the Comanche up there and see if we can land this. So I'm using the new paint. So yeah, it's kind of a freshly painted plane. Alright, so we'll do the quick run around and we'll check everything. So, first up, we will check the fuel. The fuel is full. And, yeah, so we're good. Alright, so we shall turn on the fuel and we'll do the walk around. I should be quick about this. Alright, flaps down. Oh, hang on, before I do, you know me, gotta open the bloody door. Alright, so, door's open, and flaps are down. All good. Oh, it's got the lock on it, so, yeah. Alright, we'll check everything. The battery can come on. Strobes. Yeah, it's good. Yep, all good. So, alright, so we'll move around. Alright, we'll tie the chocks out. Check around the landing gear and the wings. It looks pretty good. And we'll check the fuel tank, which is full. So, that should be full. Yep, it is full. Okay, so it's full. And we'll remove the chocks and we'll go check the fuel to make sure we don't have any water. Looks like there's no water in it. Alright, so we'll put that down. So I know if it's not down it won't shut. So yeah. Alright, so propeller's still good. Tank we've checked. Propeller. There's no marks on it. It's all still happy dories. And the oil, of course, should be still good. Ah, yep, just under 9. That's good. Alright, so we'll check the other fuel tank. I wonder how come it doesn't shut. It should lock up. It doesn't. Yeah, that's it. Yay! Alright, so that's locked. Remove the chock. Tight end can come off. The pedo cover can come off. Check the stall indicator. Wings look very good. The plane looks good. The landing gear looks nice. This side. Left, right. They have lights working. Alright. So turn the battery off. And no movement. No movement. It's uncovered, yes. Alright, so we'll undo that. Check the yeah, all good. Strobes working. Alright, so all uncovered and we'll get back in the plane. Alright, system checks complete. So, first up, we've got enough fuel in the aircraft. We'll work out which we'll work out once we're airborne and once the master switch can come on, reverse our beacon can come on, fuel mixture to fully rich. Tank to the left, and the propeller can come all the way in, and we shall put the light and we shall prime it. Our fuel pump can come on first. Fuel pump, pressure, building. Alright, so fuel pump can come off and we shall test it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and locked. Alright, so brakes are on. Make sure that they correspond on here. Yes. Alright, so we shall start the engine. So first up, ignition to both clear prop and start. So funny. I think I had the door open and it didn't shut properly. Alright, so we shall turn on the lights, which won't turn everything else on. We'll turn on the avionics master and we'll set the course. So we are here. So we are at VNRB. So the course will be VNRB. VNRB. Alright, so Rajab is something more. Okay, Luca, which is VN. Okay. Okay. Alright, so that's it's 900 feet and we're at 245 feet. So yeah, that's pretty much a distance. It's pretty thin. So anyway, we'll have a look at the map. It's roughly 17 or nautical miles. So a short flight. Alright, so what we'll do is everything's undone, everything's in, so we'll move into the wind. We'll check which way the wind's blowing. Earth's behind us. Wow, it's quite warm. There's no aircon in this plane. So we'll have to open it up. So we'll need a bit of wind to make us cool. So we're quite hot, so anyway, what I'll do is I'll leave the window open for the moment. Alright, so anyway, we shall direct ourselves into the wind. So park brake can come off. That we've all planes around this place. So many planes everywhere. What the hell? Oh, so anyway. Alright, so we'll get onto the runway and we'll work out which way. Come around this way. Alright, so we'll just do our run ups here. On the grass. That'll do. So run up checks. Drop an RPM. We're all good. So we will take off and we will track out. It's also a chance to try the autopilot too. We'll try the GPS. We'll see how we go. Alright, so we shall take off. Ah, I've got to set the... It's on west. We will set it to west. And we'll set the airport when we get there. So we don't need flaps. And this will take off this way, so yeah. Oh, it's pretty warm. Alright, I'll shut the window and lock it. Alright, so take off roll. Slowly. So yeah. Alright, so we're doing it. The reason we'll have to climb, we'll have to keep climbing out, so I will pull the prop back a bit. It'll do. As we're going up into the mountains, we'll have to climb out. So yeah. Unfortunately, I'm hoping there's going to be no ice around there, but you never know. So we'll just keep running at full power and get ourselves up to probably about, say about 7,000-8,000 feet. So, oh, I forgot to set the barometer. Alright, so we've got that set. I will line up the runway. I think the runway's facing at 9,000 feet, the airport is. Yeah, it's quite a way up. I'm hoping that we don't end up hitting cloud today, but it looks like we might have to, so we'll have to keep an eye. We don't have any icing things on this aircraft. So yeah, it's kind of really... to put everything on. Pedo can come on, strobes can come on, landing gear can stay off. Pump, we started with the pump. Oh, so slack. Alright, it's all good. So, if we run into, we're at 4,000 feet, we'll see if we'll go above it, above the clouds. Climbing at 100 miles per hour, which is pretty good for this climb. So hopefully we don't run into, it's still pretty warm, it's like 20 degrees, so yeah, it's quite warm. So it's just directly ahead. 65 nautical miles. So we'll see if we're into cloud. We might have to drop down a little bit. We can't follow the flight path because, I think we're going to be. It climbs quite well, actually. Quite a good climber. And guess what else I forgot to do? I forgot to check the controls were working properly. So we're at 20 degrees. The airport's 9,300 feet. It has no charts. Oh, that's weird. Oh, I've got the GPS. So we're 8,000. Bit of a worry today, being a little bit Oh, I think this might get a bit dodgy. We'll have a look. We'll see if we can fly. Interesting to see if we can get actually in there. Because look at the clouds everywhere. Yesterday was a good day, but today is not so good. if it's too cloudy, we'll abort. But we'll see where we go. We're at 9,000 feet. So this is roughly the height of the airport. We'll see. Just trim it down a little bit, and just a bit, that'll do. Yay! I got this idea from one of my subscribers. He likes flying the Comanche in high areas. So I thought, okay, I haven't done the Comanche in like up to 9,000 feet before, so I thought, oh, why not? And I really wanted to try this landing again because I messed up the landing in the Mustang. So yeah. It's quite windy. It gets buffeted around pretty quick, this plane does. Alright, so we'll hold it there. Whoa, it's like... I think we're on course. About 9,000. Oh, it gets buffeted around heaps. It's much different when you fly this one compared with the arrow and stuff. It'd be like going for a ride in a rock, just like. But this one stalls really funny, so yeah, it's kind of. Yeah, it's hard to keep. All right, so we've got 50 nautical miles to go. We're doing 137. So we'll get there in about 20 minutes, something like that. Alright, so... Let's see it out a bit more. That'll do. I've got the thinner spark plugs in this one, as you remember. Well, you don't know because I deleted the video that was this one, but yeah, it's got the thinner spark plugs, so hopefully, oh my god, coughing. I always cough when I talk on here, that's weird. So yeah, so I don't know if we're going to be able to get in here. Might be shrouded in fog. Alright, so I'm swapping the tanks. Well, certainly bumps around, this plane does. There's no way we can get up to Everest with this. This plane would be like, oh my god. It's so windy. We have 43 to go. We'll see if it thins out. I don't have my co-pilot with me. Oh well. She'll join me tomorrow sometime, I think. Everything's still in the green, so we're good. There's an airport nearby if we can land there if we have to. Or we can just turn around, we'll see. So, yeah. I don't think it's going to be a good day up here. If they don't break away, we're gonna have to turn around. Because yeah. We might be able to, we'll see what happens. We'll go above, we'll climb up above it. Try to. Interesting to see. Okay, we're off course a bit. Pull over this way a bit. You can see just in there, we're at 37 miles to go, 37 nautical miles to go. Remember that it's also in a valley too, so if we can't, if there's surrounded in mist and stuff in clouds, we won't be able to go in, not in this. Ah, you can see the Everest from here. This plane isn't set up for icing conditions. So yeah. essentially we have to go through that valley there. We'll see. We might get clear. We have 35 miles to go. It's bumped it around so much. a bit of carbon heat just to make sure there's no... I don't think there's anything. Temperature is still pretty high, so it's not really cold here. Funny how the GPS takes you straight over, and there's a mountain in there too. Those mountains are higher, so there's Everest, you can see it. Pretty sure it's Everest straight ahead. We might be lucky to get in. I'm gonna head down the valley. So we'll move over a fraction. And we'll follow the valley in. So we might make it after all. We'll see. Temperature slowly dropping as we get closer. Alright, so we're at 11,500 feet. And yeah. It's raining down there. So 25 nautical miles to go. Yeah. So we have to go on the right one. So we have to go in this Is there here, straight up there? Won't go too high here. So it's good to pretty much clear out the way. Normally at this height we'd be having some kind of oxygen if we were doing this, because yeah, we need alright, so we're going through there. We're at 21 nautical miles. Oh, this will be bumpy. Is at, funny how it drops down. It's at 10 degrees now, so yeah. Right, so we might be lucky to get in here somewhere. Technically, it should be through here. Head to this valley here in front of us. Yeah. We can stay on this tank for a little bit longer. But we'll have to start balancing out a bit. So, so we're 16 nautical miles from the airport. So it actually climbs quite well, this plane. So yeah, I've managed to get up to this height quite easily. It's almost zero. I'm sorry. We'll have to come down. We're too high. Alright, we'll start our descent. So we'll head over here, we'll find the landing site. Yeah. Unless there's a way in round here, but no. We'll have a look. But for me, it's like, it's quite risky. Like, you look at the fog and stuff to go in there. Yeah, it's kind of like, maybe we can go around there. Let's have a look. About 12,000 feet. We might be able to. We'll have a look and see. I can see the valley in there, so we might be lucky. We can turn around and see. It's still quite high, so. This airport is down somewhere down here. Whoa, don't know where it is. Can't see it. Not around there. Alright, so yeah. Alright, so we'll go. We might be able to. Let's have a look. See it put down there. Okay. So we might be able to get in there. We'll look around and see. Temperature's still 10 degrees. Well, that's the alternative airport is down there. So we can try So we have to go into the valley. So we can land at that runway. I think there's going to be fogged out here. We're just like, I just can't see. Down for that one. It's quite high, so alright, we'll just do a circuit around this one. So we'll slow down the plane. Which way is the wind running? That way, so we have to land that way. Whatever wrong way that is. So we'll turn around and we'll come back in. Oh, it's another dodgy area. We'll have to go around the mountain a bit. Where I talk about running close. So this one's going to be a bit tricky too. All these places are always tricky. Look at that. It's like, oh my god. Such a tricky place to land. Like, you could probably land that way. Because it's probably a better approach. We'll come down a bit further. So it's about... which way is the wind running? Yeah, we're going to have to land that way. It's 2 knots. We can land in a 2-knot wind. But still... Alright, so we'll slow down a bit more. Alright, so concern at a dodgy airport. Oh my god, why do I end up at these dodgy airports? Alright, so we're gonna go close to these trees. And we're gonna have to go around. Yeah. Alright, so. Lower the gear. And we'll put the fuel pump on, landing lights can come on, and we'll turn around for a landing. I'll leave it slightly lean for this one. And flaps can come out one. Alright, so we'll turn around right around here. We'll be real careful here. Alright, so whoa, still too high. Have to do around again. Oh, we might be able to make it that time. Two stage flaps. We should be able to land this one. That's a bit bumpy. Well, there you go. So we landed. Oh, that's kind of cool. Alright, so. Yeah. That's a bit different. So, turn around. We made it to somewhere. I have no idea where we are. Okay, we're at Pinapu or something. So yeah. Well, this is kind of below where we wanted to go, but kind of like, yeah. Oh, we've got a couple of pipers here. So, yeah. Alright, so. So we're not far. Probably a little bit. So we're in the next valley, but I don't know if it's going to be. It looks pretty fine now, so we might have to go there. Let's try. Alright, so we'll take off the brake and we'll go off. We'll try it and see. Alright, so we'll turn around and we'll just take off. It's pretty. We might be able to get out of it. Oh, hello, dude. What are you doing? Alright, so we're still on that tank. We'll swap it over. it's actually like, I don't know, we might be able to make it in. I'd like to see if I can, so yeah. Oh, look at the trees hanging up by the roots. Oh, this road's a bit bumpy for this plane. Alright, so anyway, we're all good. We're at, we're at 8,000 feet. So I'll leave the mixture a little bit leaner because of the height we are at. And so yeah. Alright, so full power and take off. I should have used flaps for that. Alright, so we'll climb around because we're going to have to do a bit of climbing. Here we go, we'll get speed back. We'll do a circuit, we'll get out of here, we'll have to climb out, so we can probably, we might be able to get out of there, so yeah, looks a bit better now since we landed. We'll go around the valley and see. So we're at 9,000. Drop into the next valley from here. So yeah, we'll see. You can be locked up. So it was an interesting little gallivant, as they say. what time is it? It's almost 9 o'clock. Alright, so anyway, we'll try. We kind of have to go around in the area. So we'll have a look. It's not far, but still. Temperature's still warm, still 10 degrees, so we're not freezing. So we're not in icing conditions. We might get there. Let's have a look. I'll leave the landing lights on. So yeah, it's quite. Over there, so it's just in there. So we should be able to get there. We're just over here. So we're coming to the valley. Right, so we'll lower the props here. Just inside this valley, it is just in there. Yeah. Alright, so. So alright, so it's just down there. So we'll slow down. Alright, gear can come down and go forward. Wrist can stay there. So we're at 9,000 feet, we're too high for it, so we'll slow down a bit. Flaps can come out one. Alright, so. Alright, so we're getting close. Oh yeah. It's just in here. So we've got one stage of flaps out, and so we're coming down. That'll do. That's it. Oh, lucky it cleared up around here. Yeah. Talk about thingos. Wow. Oh my God. Oh, so good. Oh, that is excellent. Oh my God, it's like, yay. Yay. Oh, that is so cool. I was wrapped. Alright, so flaps didn't come up. Yeah, so I have made it. Oh, I've tried the jet so many times, and then so because we're gonna stay here for tonight in the plane in this hotel area, I guess what we're gonna do. Oops. Alright, so what we'll do is we'll stand here and we'll try something exciting. So we're gonna look it up as usual. It'll do, dude. Alright, so parking brake can come on. Pedo can come off. Things can come off. Landing lights that can come off. Fuel pump can come off. And the engine can die. Alright, so what we have to do here, because we are in the deserty stuff, we have to. No, we're not gonna put the. Go back in the plane. Alright, so what we have to do is we have to put the engine heater on because we're in such a cold environment. So we've got the engine heater running. And so, yeah. Alright, so I can't be bothered doing everything, so we'll try the tie downs and we'll kill the and the magnetos and the power. Alright, so control locks will come on. Ah, I'm wrapped. So, alright, so my plane is locked down for the night. And there she is. She made it to Luca. Oh my God, I've tried so many times with her. And here I am with the Comanche. This is a great plane, I tell you. It's something. So yeah, that's great. Well, I've got to take a photo because photo opportunities as I do. Oh, look at that, the mountain in the background. It's so cool. Alright, so that'll do. There you go. Yay, photo ops. Love it. Look at that. That's fantastic. I'll take another one. This is my favorite one. Yeah, so I'm pretty happy about this. Yeah. Here. Alright, there's another photo. And I will see you on the next one. Bye for now. Have fun. Oops, what am I doing?